Florida. Nanette Diaz Barragán, she sits on the House Homeland Security Committee. Congresswoman, good to see you as always. As a member of the committee, have you learned anything tonight about this mail facility sweep? Have they told you anything about it?
We don't have anything new. I know what you know. I think first we should thank first responders. We should thank postal workers and law enforcement for being on top of this and doing everything they can to try to find this person and put a stop to it right away.
All of this comes, obviously, as officials have made it very clear today, they're not ruling out the possibility there are more explosive devices out there. Take a listen.
Any reason to believe there may be other packages like this?
Yeah, we don't know at this time.
I would assume it's not the end, which is the safe assumption.
Do you know anything about any more bombs that might be out there or any assumption about how many there might be?
We can't confirm whether there are or not. I think what is a good thing to do is to tell the American public, if you see something suspicious, call it in. We have to remain vigilant, especially at a time where we're continuing to see breaking news and new devices, new mail being put out there. So we should all be vigilant around this time. But we don't have any confirmation of how many devices are out there still, if there are any, or if this is it.
So one of the questions that I get from the public, from viewers, is we see law enforcement asking for help, and we don't know much more other than, in terms of leads, other than this mail facility in Florida. Should we assume that there's a lot more out there that the investigators know that we don't? Or they're asking us for help, does that indicate that they don't have much to go on?
Well, I think you always have investigators asking for help because they're always trying to find different leads, additional information. I don't think we can assume that they know less or they know more. I think it's the public is a tool to aid them in investigating. And so if you see anything, I think that's why it's important that they speak up, they say something. You know, you see your post person delivering something that looks suspicious. You know, I would certainly say something, but I don't think we should assume anything from what we're hearing.
Homeland Security Secretary Kirstjen Nielsen has been at the border for several days preparing for the arrival of this caravan full of migrants. Are you surprised she's not in Washington, D.C. at her office helping to lead the response to this serial bomb maker or bomb makers on the loose?
I am. Frankly, here we have an act of terrorism where people are, you know, are certainly concerned, inciting some fear. And it's a huge concern for me and the American people. Instead, what we have is a secretary down at the south border, really just doing more of what the president's doing and making the immigration issue political. I think this is a time where the country needs to come together. It could start with the president on not just unifying people, but staying there. Stop blaming the media, which is what he does all the time. Stop using divisive language. And let's get down to the bottom of what's happening and stop what is happening. And let's catch this person and focus on that, which is the real threat to this country right now.
Congresswoman Nanette Diaz Barragán, thank you so much for your time. We appreciate it, as always.